The Home Office ministers, past and present, and a wide range of officials. So, thank you, Mr. Speaker. Mr. Speaker, with permission, I'd like to group number one with question 11. Drugs, Mr. Speaker, are a scourge on society. They destroy lives, blight communities, fuel crime, and there is no safe way to take dangerous drugs. So I do not support legalising drugs. And importantly, Mr. Speaker, the drug strategy led by this government tackles drug supply, will reduce demand and also provide world-class treatment to those in need of help.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Tragically, over the summer, York saw a number of deaths caused by substance misuse. With 4,859 drug deaths in England and Wales last year, up 6.2% on the previous year, and Dame Carol Black's second report into prevention services highlighting that services are not fit for purpose, it's important that we see change based on evidence. So will the government look again at the impact evidence of overdose prevention units and pilot these, including in places like York?
Mr. Speaker, if I may, the Honourable Lady has made a very, very important point about the tragedy of drug deaths. And she's also highlighted something that's incredibly important, which is the work of Dame Carol Black. And I would, Mr. Speaker, like to pay tribute to the work of Dame Carol Black on everything that she's put forward in terms of drug strategies, but also the treatment programmes, and highlighting where funding across the whole of government needs to come together. And of course, with that, there is a great deal of work that has taken place. The Honourable Lady, Mr. Speaker, is correct. Not just more work needs to be done, but actually we need to have bottom-up solutions to this. And Dame Carol Black has put forward some strong proposals, presented them to a government, which I have backed and I have supported, along with the Prime Minister. And it is absolutely right that that legacy continues, because this will help to save lives, as well as re-establish rehabilitation programmes across the country.
And McLaughlin.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Last week I spent an evening in Glasgow with families who, like me, have lost someone to drug addiction. They and I accept that the ideal situation is that people will conquer their addictions. But will she accept that they can only do that if they don't first die? And will she accept that if they are continuing to use, we should enable them to do so as safely as possible and as close to medical assistance as possible? The RCN support drug consumption rooms. Will she support them and those families? And in memory of all those who've lost their lives to drugs, Will she just give the go-ahead for one pilot project?
Well, Mr. Speaker, if I may, and I totally recognise and understand not just the remarks of the Honourable Lady, but actually the scale of drug addiction and drug deaths. We've discussed this many times before in this House, and it's tragic, absolutely tragic. And conquering addiction is not easy, which is why, if I may, Mr. Speaker, I stand by the work of Carol Black. I think that work is pivotal in terms of putting forward long-term treatment programmes, because long-term treatment is really required. My views are known on drug consumption rooms in particular, but I do think, Mr. Speaker, there are no easy answers and solutions to this, because people who are addicted to drugs are taking drugs for a wide range of reasons. It's important that we seek to help them, support them, and conquer addiction and help them to rebuild their lives.
Tom Hearn.
Question number two, Mr. Speaker.
Minister.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. The government takes a dual approach, combining tough enforcement with programmes that